I'm nervous.
Okay, so if you've been on our channel before, you will know that since the conception of this channel and our very first video, the person in our system who made it was our host, Chloe. Chloe created debunking DID, she birthed Dissociated, she did all the planning, all the filming, all the editing, all the uploading, the social media care, everything. This channel was Chloe's baby. She was so dedicated to challenging misconceptions, erasing stigma, helping people, doing something important with our life. And I bet some of you are wondering why I'm using past tense. I'm the integrated result of Nina, our sexual protector, and Chloe, our host, integrating. This channel is about dissociative identity disorder. It used to be known as multiple personality disorder. It's a trauma-related neurodevelopmental dissociative disorder that occurs when children experience repeated trauma in childhood and the personality doesn't fully integrate in normal development, leading to separate personalities rather than a fully whole and coalesced one. People with DID don't always stay with the same alters throughout their lifetime. All these personalities are separated by amnesic walls, which means memory loss, amnesia. This is how the host, the person who fronts and is in the body most often, is able to stay unaware of what happened to them as a child and what may have still been happening as they grew up. As alters heal and come to terms with their abuse or trauma, whatever happened to them, or in the opposite way around, they become unable to cope, it kind of defeats the purpose of the brain having separated them off. The reason DID exists is to be a coping mechanism, to allow that child to survive what they went through. Some alters are unable to cope with that knowledge, or it becomes too much. When this happens, there are two things that an alter can do. It's not always a conscious choice. That alter can go dormant, which basically means going to sleep for a very long period of time, becoming inactive, or integrating. Integrating is when those amnesic barriers that separate off parts of the consciousness to form different alters break down. People have compared it to fusion and Steven Universe.
Why is your sandal too small for your feet? Steven. Connie! I did it!
You did it?
Wait. Ugh, this. No. This is great! Oh my gosh, look at you now!
When two gems kind of meld together to become a new gem. That gem, that person, that alter is more than just the sum of their previous parts. They become a new person, but the other alters who were there originally become part of them. So those alters no longer exist in their own right, but they have come together to form someone that can deal better with the situations and the memories that they held together. The idea of integration is that we're stronger together than apart. I'm the new host of the Dissociated System. I'm going to be running the channel from now on. I'm the integrated result of Nina, our sexual protector, and Chloe, our host, integrating. I have all of Chloe's memories, and most of Nina's. There are things that I can't and won't touch yet, trauma stuff, especially on Nina's side. I'm not Chloe as I was before. I'm not Nina as I was before, but I'm still them. I'm just also me. I'm still going by the name Chloe. Some people have picked up the nickname Nin for me, which I quite like as well, but I am using the name Chloe officially. I integrated on either the 28th or the 29th of September of this year, 2019, so I'm still relatively new to existing as I am now and discovering who I am and what that means. Everything's very different now. We didn't choose to integrate. I didn't
want to exist like this. I didn't ask to exist. The channel that Chloe created was always meant to be professional, educational, and supportive, but somewhat removed from our own life and our personal healing journey. Since so many of you have been with us for over a year now and have given so much to support us, I feel like the least we can do is give you an explanation, and I want to share this with you. If you've been with us from the start, you'll know that we didn't like to talk about integration. It scared us. All the system had a huge fear of it. We didn't really understand it. It was frightening and unknown. The more we got to know other people with DID, the more we learned about DID and experienced up close with our partner system, another person that we're dating who has DID, experiencing them integrating and talking to integrated alters in their system made it a lot less frightening and unknown. It kind of made us more comfortable with the concept. I think that that's part of the reason why this happened now. Chloe was struggling a lot. Nina had been struggling for a long time. I didn't see why I still existed if I, as Nina, couldn't do the things that I had been taught to do to protect us. I couldn't do anything I wanted to do to have fun because all of those things I'd learned were unhealthy coping mechanisms. I didn't feel like I could cope with the world around me, neither did Chloe. Her eating disorder started to take over our lives. The integration happened when Nina spoke to our partner system about some things that had happened, including an integration that happened in their system. Chloe had been trying to reach out to Nina for over a year. Nina was really struggling. I, as Nina, didn't believe anything anyone ever said to me. Chloe was the first person I started to trust in thinking that maybe she actually saw me as a person rather than just someone who can be used to fulfill various wants, needs, and desires. As a sexual protector, that's kind of what I'd learned I was. It took over a year, but I finally opened up and I said everything I needed to say. It all came out in one go. How I felt about trauma, how I felt about myself, people, the world, it all came out. People asked, what can we do? I'm so sorry, how can we help you? What can we do? And my response as Nina was, there's nothing to do. I've accepted this the way it is and I think it's time to just leave it now. Let's just move on. This is what's happened and there's nothing else to do. I finally felt like I'd been able to put down the weight that I was carrying for so long, that I was ready to move forward. I don't really know how it happened. Pretty sure it happened while we were asleep. The next morning at 4 a.m, we were woken up by our partner system calling and they'd had an integration. We helped them through that and then went back to sleep. And I had this dream, but I don't think it was a dream. I, as Nina, was standing in a room by myself. A room without walls. It was just kind of like a dark space with a wooden floor. I finally felt like I was ready to breathe. I took off all my clothes, I dropped them on a pile on the floor, and I walked forward into the darkness. And then when I woke up in the morning, I was me. Chloe and Nina are me. The way the brain processes integration is different for every system and for every integration within every system. I think the way that our mind visualized what happened makes sense for us. If you've been following us on Instagram, you'll know that I've been really struggling with this. I've spoken to people who've integrated before. We've done videos on our channel with people who've been integrated before. A lot of times they've said, you know, they've missed themselves. And I was like, oh, I kind of understand that, but it's kind of odd, kind of difficult to understand how you can miss yourself, like the people you used to be. I get it now. I get it now. It's hard to be reborn into the same life, but with different connections to everybody you know, different memories about what happened, the people you knew, two separate timelines of memories that happened at the same time, but from different perspectives, traits from both alters. I have Nina's strength, perseverance, her extreme emotions. All my emotions now are so overwhelming and constant. For the first 4 days, it was crippling. I felt extreme guilt for integrating, for taking Chloe and Nina away from the people who loved them, for taking myself away from the people I loved, for losing the relationships I cared about so much because I'm different now. I still love the people I loved. Bless me. And I sneeze a little bit different too. My art is different now as well by a little bit. My handwriting is a little bit different. I don't think I speak that much different, but sometimes I can hear like more of Nina's voice coming out of my mouth or more of Chloe's voice coming out of my mouth, that I've learned not to psychoanalyze myself that much. It makes sense that there are three parts to me. Me as I am now, Chloe's influence and Nina's influence. But I'm me. I'm a whole person on my own, and I don't need to try and rip myself into pieces so that they'll make sense in the way that they did before. Integration is torturous, or at least it has been for me. Chloe didn't want to integrate. I don't think Nina intended to. This is our first real integration in the system that hasn't happened deep, deep in a world. And that integration we didn't find out about till months later. That was with two of our persecutors. Having the first integration that we're really aware of involve our host, our long-term host, me, the person who had the tightest relationships with everybody, has been very, very, very intense. It's normal with DID to experience extreme denial. The whole nature of dissociative identity disorder is that the host, until they're told really, or until something happens and they find out, shouldn't know that they have DID and alters, because that's how the disorder keeps them safe. It's by hiding that knowledge, that awareness of the terrible repeated trauma in childhood and throughout life from them so that they can function normally. I still had that as Chloe, even though we've been professionally diagnosed. Our life kind of revolves around trying to help this community. Don't have that denial anymore. I can't. I could not fake this, subconsciously or not. I'm a different person. Everything is different. That is so scary. This is the scariest thing that's happened since me as Chloe started having DID take over our life before we were diagnosed, and losing everything. Everything. Our education, our friends, our partner, our home, our future, our control over our own body. Everything. We lost everything. But I haven't lost anything except the people I used to be, and they're still part of me. I know some of you felt very connected to Chloe, and she loved you, and I still love you. I still care about you all, and I care about this channel, and I care about the messages that I'm giving. It's still my voice, it's just a little different now. But it's okay to grieve the people I was if you feel you need to. It's okay to miss them, but I'm not really gone. I don't know what I thought integrating would be like if it finally ever happened to us, and we weren't really ever thinking that it would. It just didn't cross our minds. But I didn't think it would be this hard. There is guilt, grief, anger, frustration, the unpredictability of not knowing who you are and how you'll react to things. I don't know who I am. And still hosting and, you know, trying to take care of everyday life, but with all these extra memories, the relationships to the people that we knew that I've built over years being slightly different. Looking different in the inner world. I have brown eyes, blonde hair now. I'm 5'4" and this body is 5'1". I'm very slender, very slender. The channel isn't gonna change. We're still gonna bring you the content that you know and love. We're still dedicated to protecting and supporting and trying to make a difference in this community. And for this community and the rest of the world. I'm still so passionate about that, about all mental health disorders and raising awareness for them. I'm an advocate. This is gonna take some time to get used to, and I'd really appreciate it if you don't try and psychoanalyze me, because it's hard enough me doing that to myself. I really hope that even though I'm not the person you knew before on this channel, that you guys will stay with us. Who knows, maybe the content will be a little bit different, but it still has the same message. I'm still going to be doing debunking DIDs. It's harder to do them now. Bringing you all that scientific stuff. All the nitty-gritty stuff. But also maybe sharing a little bit more first-hand experience, because we're not perfect. I'm glad that we get to bring attention to this community. But I want to do it in the right way. But we're still mentally ill, traumatized people with DID. It's scary to share that side of our life. But I think sometimes that's just as important as the logical side of things. You can read about as many studies as you want, but until you hear about it from someone's heart, straight out their mouth, sometimes it just doesn't touch you. I'm feeling very ill today. I promise I'm not usually this much of a sad sack. I'm apparently, well, I'm a lot more flirtatious now. I'm a lot more confident. I'm a lot more able to use the body. I'm a lot more physically capable. Apparently have a sassier twinge to my voice when I don't feel like I'm dying, because today I feel awful. I have the worst headache ever. But yeah, I'm looking forward to getting to know you guys a little better. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click that bell button. That's important. Click the bell button if you're subscribing, and I hope that you still enjoy the content we bring you. I look forward to getting to know you guys a little bit better, and let's see where this goes. I've still got plans. Lots of love, everybody. Bye.